Everyone was 20 plus. There were like a couple of young kids. I'm not saying that's bad. I'm not saying that's bad. If you're like 15 or whatever, that's fine. But I'm just saying majority was like 20 plus, which is fucking cool, you know? And then like I signed 4 or 5 mouse pads, which is kind of funny. And I took a picture with a baby, which was kind of funny. I met these Japanese dudes. Where's my money, bitch? Yeah, I met these Japanese dudes. There were like 3 Japanese dudes. Apparently they like, I didn't know, but Twitch opened up like an office in Japan recently. They were fucking cool. That was an experience. And then this one girl cried when she met me. That was fucking weird. What else happened? I tried the Vive. Dude, the Vive was fucking sick. The Vive was cool as fuck. Actually, I don't do this. I don't do this, but, what the HTC, sorry, the HTC Vive, basically it was like this little area in the back right of the convention. You walk, it's like a black box. And if you like go there, it's like reservations are full. Like you can't get into the Vive. So I like walked up, I was like, oh shit, like is it full? And they're like, yeah. And this guy, actually no, it wasn't a guy. My bad. It was T-Mac. I was walking around with T-Mac. As I was about to go, T-Mac was like, yo man. To the HTC guy, T-Mac was like, yo man, you're making a big mistake not letting him in. Do you know who he is? And he's like, who are you? I was like, Lirik. And then he's like, 1 second. And then they made room for me and I tried out the Vive. I don't do name drops like that. Like, I'm not a fucking asshole. But, like, that was kind of funny. Because, like, I had some leverage because of that. So that was cool. And I tried the Vive. And that was fucking insane. Because I have the Oculus Rift. And, I haven't used it yet. But, like, the Vive, you walk around in like 3D space. You don't like sit there with your thumb up your ass. You like walk around and like do shit. And it's cool if you're gonna like hit the, if you're gonna hit, or if you get close to the box, it shows a grid pop up. So like if you put your hand out, you touch the wall. So you don't like fucking run into a wall or something. There was like this one VR experience where you're like basically on the Titanic and there's like this big ass whale that comes and tries to scare you. And then there's this other one. Oh, the coolest one is you draw shit in 3D space. That was fucking mind-blowing. Like, Gears would love that shit. I wrote hello and drew a cat. And like it's like all around you. It's so hard to describe it. It looked amazing. You can make it like snow on yourself and shit. And then I played Fruit Ninja in VR. You know, like that iPhone, the phone game where you slice fruit. But like, in virtual reality. It was fucking awesome. Yeah, it was pretty cool. And like when she handed me the controllers, like first when you put it on, you're just like chilling. And then like she, like it was a girl. She's like, okay, I'm gonna put the controllers in your hands. And like you take the controllers and when you lift up your hand, it's so fucking weird because you don't see your arm. All you see is like a controller in like virtual reality. And it feels like you're a fucking robot kinda. It's hard to describe. It's one of those things. It's really fucking cool though. And, oh yeah, and then I met Almir. You guys know Almir, chills in the channel a lot and usually drops fucking, tip bombs. I fucking met Almir. Wicked cool guy. That picture of me in the wheelchair, that was Almir's VR. His company is working on virtual reality. That's why I was in the wheelchair. Because, actually, can I talk about that? I think so, why not? The way it worked is like it's the Walking Dead VR. They're working on a new game and it's like one is not VR, one is VR, this one is VR. And you're meant to be a dude in a hospital and you're weak, so you're on a fucking wheelchair. And there's like this chick that like pushes you around. And you're trying to escape the hospital when there's zombies all over the place. And they give you a shotgun and you're supposed to aim and fucking shoot the zombies. It was cool. It was really fucking cool. That's why. So yeah. It was an experience. It was a fucking experience. Slarba, thank you for the resub. Retardio, wake up at 5 a.m. Anna Daisy, how are you, Anna? Afro, thank you for the resub. Coffee, thank you for subbing. Dev Xer, thank you for the resub. Sinsta, Solid Snake, Moose, Serbal Grog, Solus, thank you guys. Thor Bini, thank you for subbing. Phoenix, Blue Sandwich, Prophet Junk, Jordan, fucking Sita, Hisa's Cargus, thank you guys very much. All of you guys for the resubs. Arishakal 2, thank you for subbing, man. And Toxibomb, Eating a Unicorn, Deer Hunter, thank you guys very much. You're too kind. This is so backed up. What else happened? Thursday? Let me go in order. Thursday was kind of... Wait, hold on. Fuck, I don't even remember. Thursday we landed. And then I think we just did dinner Thursday. No. Thursday was the monster cat party. That was fucking insane, dude. That's when I got shit-faced. Mainly because of Towly and soda popping. That wasn't my fault. They made me do a lot of shots. And like, my mouth is small, so I can't like... I can't do a full one.
Hey, Lirik. Welcome back. Missed the streams, Lirik.
Lirik. Thank you very much for the $50, Wilhelmsen 12. Thank you, man. Thank you very much. You're crazy, dude. Yeah, I can't do like a full shot. I need to do like 3/4 and then another sip. or else it like overflows. I don't fucking know. But yeah, that happened. I don't really do shots ever. It's fucking nasty. But yeah, that happened, and, I met a bunch of people. There was this one guy at the party, who came up to me, and he was, like, wicked drunk. He's like, yo, man, like, never stop what you're doing, man. You're, like, an inspiration, man. Ugh. Like, dude, you're so cool, man. And he was like that for, like, 5 minutes, and I was just, like, nodding my head. And then he walked away, and he, like, and then he was, like, and then I think he fell because he was so drunk, and people had to help him up. So that was cool. I met Waffle there. I barely hung out with Waffle at all. I was so fucking like, I don't know. I hung out with like so many other broadcasters than Waffle. Like PAX East, it was literally did everything with Waffle. This one, I fucking mainly hung out. Thursday, I hung out with like... I hung out with JP and Shannon Sacriel, and it's kind of it. And then like the rest of the con, I literally hung out with Soda Poppin, Leah, Forsen, and Wreckful sometimes. Like the whole con. And they were fucking cool as hell. Forsen is the fucking man. Like him and I connected. We fucking talked like... I think I talked to him the most the whole con. He's a really laid back, chill dude. Fucking cool as fuck. Leah, she's fucking cool as hell too. Where's my money? Yeah, man. Forsen's the fucking man. That guy, I fucking connected with him like instantly. Leah's cool as fuck. She's easy to talk to and stuff. Very cool. You know, Soda Poppin', I've never met him, you know, and like fucking... Oh, also I hung out with Scoots. What up, Scoots? Yes, I did. Scoots is always a sight for sore eyes. Fucking Soda, like, you know, the problem with like internet shit is that you don't really know people other than like the bullshit Twitch chat spreads about you or about someone else, right? But like... Whatever. That's like the only thing I knew about him. You know? That's it. I never met him, but I met him at TwitchCon and we fucking hung out for like 2 days. Like we ate together and we just fucking chilled together for a long fucking time. And I also met Tim kind of the same way, but not to the extent of Soda Poppin', because I've known about Soda, like, you know, since the beginning, but Tim I knew slightly of, and Tim was cool as fuck too. Very easy dude to talk to, and we chilled, and it was like, it was just fucking cool, man. It was just really fucking cool. But yeah, Tim, Soda, and Leah, and Forsen were the main people I hung out with a lot. Yeah. Oh shit. Okay, for all the old school viewers out here, I don't know if you remember, it was like DayZ days, old school DayZ mod days. If you remember, this is for old school, probably only like 200 of you guys remember. There is a scene, or not a scene, but there is a time when me, Shorty, and Waffle were running around Cherno, and there was a guy singing Under the Sea, that Little Mermaid song, okay? And I met him at the meet and greet. Yeah. He was at the meet and greet. Yep. Where's my money? And he was fucking there. And I was like, my mind was kind of blown. And he's like, yeah, man, like, after that happened, I, like, donated to you and told you that it was, like, me who was the Under the Sea guy. And you were like, don't ever utter that word again. That man is sacred. And, like, he met me and at the fucking con. He didn't take a picture or anything. He just, like, was like, yo, man. Yeah, it was, like, nice to meet you and stuff. Or it was cool finally seeing you. I don't know. That was fucking surreal because it was kind of like a blast from the past as well. Money, it's like, seriously, man. The dude who sang on the stream. Oh, I also met... Oh, on the street. Oh, it was so fucking random. The dude who... in A3L... fuck, I wish I took a picture with him. The dude who plays... Okay, there's... In A3L, there's Grandpa, and then there's the other Grandpa, the one with, like, a higher voice. I don't know how to describe it. Maybe we'll see him one day soon in A3L. I see him sometimes. He usually wears, like, that black hat with, like, the spikes, the red spikes. I saw him. He came up to me. He's like, hey, man, you recognize my voice? And he did a little bit of it. And I was like, oh, shit. And old man Joe, was that him, T-Mac? Was that him? Also, I talked to T-Mac a lot. T-Mac's the fucking... He's a cool dude. T-Mac's a bro. I talked to him a lot. He was shit-faced, though, I could tell. At least on Thursday. Yeah, I met him on the street. That was weird. He's like, yo, man, recognize the voice? Yeah, he was at the music event. He was. Where's You're right. Money, bitch? You're right. I'm sorry. I'm missing a lot of your guys' shit. I'm just talking a lot. Shadow, thank you for subbing. Nailed, thank you for subbing. Erish Kagal, thank you for subbing, dude. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Black Goose, thank you for subbing. Coffee. The Orbean, thank you. What up, guys? Toxibomb. I did. Dude, Summit and I always connect. Like, we're cool. I didn't hang out with him too much, but we hung out. Well, we had to Uber to the Twitch offices to do some shit and, like, get a tour of the Twitch offices, just him and I. And it was cool. The Twitch offices are fucking... Honestly, it doesn't really look like an office. It just looks like a chill area. It's like, you just walk in, and it's like, cafeteria. And then you take a couple of steps, computers everywhere. Take some more steps, computers fucking everywhere. You know? And, like, they have a bunch of cool fucking pictures. And, what else? They have, like, a kitchen and a cafeteria. Like, a bunch of help-yourself food. I don't know, I kept looking at the food there. That was weird. You could just do, like... Just fucking go and eat there and just, like, go back to your desk. And when we went, a bunch of people were, like, playing Counter-Strike and stuff. Slackers! Aldo the Apache, thank you for subbing. Oh, yeah, they do have a bar. They do. A fuck ton of alcohol there. Actually, you're right. Shorty, I like how you knew that, and I didn't point that out. Nailed, thank you for subbing. And Obscure, thank you. Yeah, it's, like, literally, it's like ramen. Just pick it up, heat that shit up, and go back to your computer. It seemed more like a big-ass dorm. Or a big apartment. Not really an office. Which isn't bad. It seemed like a really chill environment, if you know what I mean, right? Like a very, very chill environment. Like, I could see myself working there and just chilling. But yeah, and then we had lunch there. Oh, fuck. Oh my god, how could I forget? Dude, there's so much stuff that happened and I'm, like, skipping shit. Thursday was an experience because Thursday, the Monster Cat party was fucking crazy. That's what happened. That's the problem. Okay? Because, like, there's so much shit that happened, but it's because we stayed up all night. Because I didn't even sleep Thursday, and I went to the con on Friday without any sleep. After my flight and everything. Because it was so insane. Thursday, Monster Gap Party, I met Soda Poppin' and Tally. Tally I did shots with. Soda Poppin' I did shots with. And then, Soda Poppin' and I danced. And he kept telling me to, like, pick him up. And then we both ate shit on the ground. And then he messaged me and he's like, dude, I don't remember what happened. And I told him he molested me, but I liked it. That's what I remember. And then that happened. And then after that, I think Soda, like, he just left because he was so drunk. And, what do you call it? I met Gold Glove. Oh my fucking god. Gold Glove is a character. That man is fucking insane. I've never seen someone talk so much about sucking dicks in my entire life. Until I met Gold Glove. So that was fucking weird. That was actually really weird. Oh my god. I'm not really sure what happened there, but I remember we were, like, in an Uber for, like, an hour looking for a place to eat. And, like, Google kept saying there were IHOPs open for 24 hours, but all the three we went to were all closed. And then we found, like, a Denny's in some shitty-ass hotel that we ate at with, like, a bunch of people. So that was weird. And, yeah. I don't even remember what happened, actually. It was so fucking weird. That was a trip. Rygar, thank you for subbing. And Fevi, thank you very much for subbing. Julia TV, I don't think I saw you there, Julia. But thank you for subbing. I don't remember if I did. I don't think I did. I remember you from PAX East. Gus Wern, thank you for the resub. Yeah, man, that was fucking insane. But yeah, that happened. Did he suck your dick? Well, that's what I'm saying. I don't remember. I do not remember. Did I like San Fran? No. Fuck no. I didn't like San Fran at all. I'm gonna be honest with you. I fucking love San Diego. I've been to Comic-Con like 3-4 times. San Diego is fucking gorgeous. It's like 70 degrees, palm trees, and it's like very clean. San Fran, what the fuck? Okay? I don't know what is going on in San Fran. Granted, maybe the convention was kind of in a shitty place, but like it was straight up hobos, people playing drums, and every time you exited, there was fucking traffic. I've never seen so much fucking traffic in a city in my entire life. And what's funny is, that was every single day in fucking San Fran. And it was funny, because on Sunday when I got back to Boston, holy shit, it's like night and day, dude. Boston, it was like clean as fuck, it was beautiful, no traffic whatsoever. And then like we went to the Italian part of Boston and ate there, it was fucking beautiful. I was like, thank you, thank you. But granted, when I went to the Twitch offices, there was traffic there. But it was a lot nicer because that was the financial district of San Fran, where that's located. So, that was nice. Maybe it was just in a shitty part. Dude, I got, like, it was late nights every time in San Fran, and I don't think I've ever been asked so many times for a fucking dollar. Like, it was insane. I was scared half the time. Like, someone was gonna... I don't know, dude. It was some creepy shit. I'm just saying, if you're a girl, never walk alone. Honestly, even if you're a guy, never walk alone in San Fran. You're most likely gonna get fucked. Literally and metaphorically. Spofon, thank you for the resub. Compilation and Mad Hatter UI, thank you for subbing. Oh, dear God. That shit is fucking freaky. I don't know, man. It's like drunk hobos everywhere. Holy fuck. Money? Yeah, I'm being dead serious. Never walk alone at night in San Fran. At least we're near the convention area and all that shit. Have I been to New York? I have been to New York, but I don't remember New York being, like, that ridiculous. I've been to New York, like, 4 times, and it's never been that ridiculous. I can finally get laid. You know what, man? That's one way of looking at it. Dynamus, thank you for the resub. What else happened? So yeah, Thursday was a trip. Friday. Guys, by the way, you guys who tipped and shit, it's so backed up that it hasn't updated on my program yet. That's why. Just hold on. It's literally queued. So I can't even read what you wrote to me until this calms down a little bit. Oh yeah, I did meet Gears. I did meet Gears. It was fucking cool meeting Gears, man. It was awesome. Gears has been with me since, like... Where's my money? I've known Gears since the start of... streaming, basically. And, it was fucking cool seeing him. Gears was all sweaty. I don't remember that. I don't remember that at all. But, like, yeah, I've known Gears since, like, the beginning of streaming, and finally seeing him was, like, wicked cool, dude. It was wicked fucking cool. It was really, really fucking cool. You know, seeing the man behind Lyric Thump. Seeing the man behind this shit and all the art he's made. You know, Gears is taller than you? Yeah, he is. It was cool, man. It was cool. It was awesome. I did chill a lot with Pocket as well. Usually in conventions, me and Pocket always chill. What else happened? Fuck, dude. There's so many people I met. Like, no one, like, rubbed me the wrong way. That's kind of, like, the cool thing about Twitch. It's all like-minded people, you know? You're all fucking nerds. So it's, like... Yeah, you're all fucking nerds, but, you know, you can be a nerd, but you still can't really connect with someone, like, you don't know how to talk to them, if you know what I'm saying. Yeah, like, I don't know how to describe it, but, like, sometimes in conversation, you sit there, and there's awkward silence, and usually those are the people you don't really connect with, if you know what I'm saying. And, at TwitchCon... there was always something to talk to with, like, everyone I saw. Whether it was, like, chilling with, like, Leah or Soma or, like, fucking, Soda Poppin or, like, Tim or, like, Forsen. Oh, and I met Wreckful. Dude, I kind of fangirled a little bit over Wreckful because, like, you know, I played a lot of World of Warcraft and stuff. He was a cool motherfucker. I slow danced with him at the, on Saturday. But we were, you know, we were both shit-faced. At least I was. And he's a cool dude. Him and his girlfriend are really fucking cool. I didn't think we'd connect. But it was, like, wicked fucking cool talking to him. Very, very cool. Very cool guy. Very cool dude. That happened. That's why I'm sick? You think so? I'm not that sick, as long as it doesn't get worse. Like, I can function. It's more like annoyance. Like, annoying sickness. Stuffy nose and sore throat. With a hint of losing my voice. Yeah, dude, the concert. I actually got a shout-out at the concert. That was kind of cool, but it wasn't streamed. People were telling me they, like, shouted me out, and I was like, oh, check that off the fucking list of accomplishments. Get a shout out at a fucking EDM concert. Xenocide, thank you for subbing. Pruny, Andres, Axehead, Vindicator, thank you guys for the resubs. Yeah, I didn't do any panels. No, I didn't want to do any. I only did the meet and greets. I barely played any... I didn't even check the show floor. I was so fucking busy. There was so many other stuff to do that I never checked half the shit. Like, I wanted to try Paladins and stuff, and, like... Honestly, fuck games. When you go to a convention, the last thing you want to do is play video games, actually. So I'm not that pissed or annoyed. Morph, thank you for subbing. I didn't meet Crip. I slightly met Trump, but it was like, hi, and then that nothing happened. I went to dinner with Amaz, but we, you know, We didn't go all out. Who else did I meet? I met a bunch of smaller broadcasters that were cool. Moroccan Tomato, thank you for subbing. Yeah, I did meet T-Mac. I'm just thinking, there's so much shit that happened. I'm trying to like scan it in my mind. I'm trying to fucking remember everything. I didn't meet Echo. I didn't. I know I met Pocket. I said that. I hung out with Pocket a lot. JP I met. Ammunition. Tally. Lula. Fucking. Oh yeah. Fairlight I met. Oh, Trick2G I met. Yeah, dude. Trick2G is cool. He's a cool motherfucker. I met him at PAX East too. He's a cool guy. Dan's Gaming. At PAX East, I hung out a lot with Dan and Waffle. This time, I was nowhere near them. That's what I'm saying. I had a completely different experience because I hung out with absolutely different people. Like, people I didn't think I'd hang out with at all, I hung out with. Yeah, that's what happened. Like, PAX East, it was like Dan, you know, Waffle, you know, just chilling. You know, like, the people who are just, like, very, like, laid back. But, like, this shit... fucking insane with like Forsen and stuff. Like, I would have never thought I'd hang out with Forsen, but I literally hung out with him the whole fucking con. I slightly met Day 9, like a little bit. That's like, I shook his hand and that was it. I met DJ Wheat, he was a cool dude. I talked to him for a little bit. I think on Thursday I talked to him for a little bit. I slightly met Raynad. I was like, hey man, what's up? I'm Lyric. He's like, yo, I know you, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, we knew each other. And that was that. Oh, I did meet Kappa. Oh, that was fucking funny. They had, like, this VIP area. Like, I kind of... That's where I met Wreckful for the first time. There's, like, this third floor VIP area. Kind of just to, like, rest and chill. Like after, if you don't want to, you know, if you just want to calm down a little bit, that's where I went. And, I saw fucking the Kappa dude. And it was funny cause like I saw him walking in to the VIP area and it literally he had like a blank stare on, and I started laughing my ass off because I knew that he probably got fucking surrounded and like mobbed beyond belief, and he like finally made it to the promised land. It was funny as fuck. Like, he had death on his face. Can you imagine that shit? I'd be scared. Like, literally, he like, you could just tell he was so fucking burnt out when I saw him. I was like, yeah, I know what happened to you, bro. Don't worry about it. I feel you, bro. I feel you, man. Calm down. I feel you, man. But yeah, you could tell he's like, don't fuck with me, I don't want to talk to anyone. Cyber Skull, thank you for subbing. Appreciate it, man. Miss Harvey, no. I did meet Bike Man. We didn't get to talk too much, but I met Bike Man. Always a pleasure. After my second signing, as I was leaving... Okay, I had the most awkward... You kind of had to be there, but I did meet Darude, but it was really fucking awkward. Because I don't know why he was there, actually, now that I think about it. Why he was in that area. I got done on Saturday with my second signing, and it's like, okay, man, hour's up, you gotta go. And I was walking away, and, like, the area where you have to walk out of, right next to the meet and greet, Darude and I think his girlfriend or wife were right there. And I, like, walked up to him, and I was like, hey, man... Oh, I like your stuff. And like we shook hands and we just had like an awkward stare for like a minute and a half. And then I was like, and I just like walked away. I don't know, man. It was really awkward though. It's hard to describe. You have to be there. But it's like usually like a follow up. But I didn't know what to say because it's like I don't like fully like him. All I know him for is fucking Sandstorm. So it was really fucking weird. And I just, like, walked away. Because I didn't know what to say. And, yeah. It was so fucking weird. Now that I think about it, it's really fucking weird. Longtime viewer here from Morocco. Love watching you since the day Z days. Finally upgraded my credit card to sub to my favorite. I missed it. Hold up. This shit still needs to catch up. That was weird, man. I wasn't expecting it to be there, but it's like he was there, so I might as well, like, you know, introduce myself a little bit. Leet Bomb, thank you for subbing. Lazy Me DK, thank you for the resub. Cyber Skull, thank you for subbing. And Moroccan Tomato, thanks again, dude. Yeah, that was interesting. I didn't see Cutie Pie, no. I'm trying to remember who else I saw. Trying to remember. Oh, I met Captain Sparkles. He was kind of cool. Cool dude. Shit, what else, man? I'm thinking. Friday and Saturday were like the biggest fucking days. Sunday, nothing happened. Sunday was just like, go home. Majority of people left on Sunday, I think. I did meet Witwix, yes. Alright, Bike, I got you. I'll do it right now. Yo, Bike, I already got one, dude. I'm good. Thank you, though, man. I already got one. Thank you, man. Yes. Man vs. Game, I didn't meet. Yeah, dude, I didn't fucking meet Man vs. Game. Like, at all. I didn't fucking see him. Whatsoever. Yo, I heard. Oh, my car is affected. I felt really sad. You know the whole VW bullshit? With the emission bullshit? Apparently, all these cars are worth less than they actually are now. So, like, my Audi is even worth less. I don't know how it works, though, because I don't know. It's like the residual value when you sign the contract when you buy a car. Does it uphold that residual value, or can that value change now that they fucked us? I don't know how it works. I don't know. I leased my car, so fuck, man. I loved Audis too. Like, I wanted to get another one once my lease was up. But I'm not entirely sure. I'm not gonna fucking sue them. I don't know. I'll leave that to the other motherfuckers. I heard like 2 million cars are affected. Mine's 2015, so mine's probably fucked too. Wait, it's only diesel? Someone said that. Only TDI engines? I'm almost positive my car says TDI. I don't know. Someone look up a 2015 Audi A4 and tell me if it's affected. Milkshake, thank you for subbing. It's only diesel? Oh, okay, never mind then. Ha! We're good! Never mind. Wait, what Audi uses diesel? It's only TDI. If it's on a lease, you can probably swap it for a gasoline. If you have TDI, it's a diesel. Dude, I don't fucking know. I thought diesel was only for, like, trucks and shit. Most of the Euro ones. Dude, I don't know shit about cars, alright, man? I just fucking press a button and put gas in my car depending on the octane, alright? You fucking European people who are, like, born with car knowledge. I am African Jesus. Thank you for subbing. Thank you, man. I don't know, man. I have a diesel Audi. One second, guys. Hold on. Alright, what else happened? Actually no, I got some tea with, ginger in it. You learn about that stuff in driving school? Really? My driving school was a week of an old man telling me stories about fucking crashes, actually. I don't know what fucking driving school you went to. But my driving school was the old man talking about that and me cheating off this Indian kid. not really cheating, but we just, you know, I was like, we just pretended we were working together on the test. Everyone in the class was. He didn't even fucking notice. It was one of those like, oh, yo, I think this is right. But like, I didn't know what the fuck I was talking about. And I just like circled what he circled. Endangered species. Thank you for the resub. Bitch, I haven't gotten a ticket in 5 years. I don't need any training. And I speed like a motherfucker. I'm just really lucky, apparently. Because I don't know how I haven't gotten a ticket yet. Yes. Yeah, one thing for sure, I like I smoked some weed yesterday, and well, I tried driving, and they don't lie. You definitely fall asleep very easily if you try driving. I did take a lot, but I had to get home. That was interesting. They're like, yo, man, you know, I have, you know, I think I almost fell asleep like 4 times for like a second. It was like 4 a.m. though. That accounted for it too. That was interesting. Yeah, dude, I'm actually, this is kind of random, but I'm going to probably, I'm gonna, because it's decriminalized in Mass, so I'm probably gonna get a license and start smoking. Dead serious. Rerose and Giratina, thank you guys for subbing. That was a very random leeway or leadway to a different subject, but dead serious, I'm gonna do that. I used to smoke like freshman year of college, and after TwitchCon, I miss it, so I'm gonna do that shit. I'm down. Do it like maybe once a week. Not go all. I know some people who smoke every fucking day. I'll do it like once a week. I might get like the oil and vape. Keep it simple and easy instead of getting like a bong. I'm not joking, I'm being dead serious. I don't know how it's a big deal. Like, if you've smoked before, it's like really not that big of a deal. You guys are acting like it's insane, but it's really not. Hello, Lirik H, I missed you. Can I get a motherfucking Lirik H? Alright, today's stream is like catch up, get back into the groove. I fucking missed you guys. I just need to let go of a lot of things until we get back into the groove. Yeah, it's like, you know what it reminds me of? Everyone always like gets all like, ooh, when you talk about like sex and shit. It's the same shit with weed. People are like, oh my god, you can't talk about that, man. Like 420, you know? Shut the fuck up. It's really not that bad. No, it's decriminalized in like Mass, and you can go get a license, just in case. And you can buy like oil online and just put that shit in a vape. I'm gonna do that. I just need to do some research on vape and find out something good. No, I'm not high right now. I did have a great sleep, though. YouTubeBot, thank you for subbing. Welcome back. You have been missed. What up, Zorber? I know, dude. Welcome. Thank you. Will you do it on stream? No, like I said, like once on a weekend, maybe at night. Or on Thursdays or some shit. I did. I tried Swedish snus as well. I don't know if I should say who gave it to me, just in case. I don't know how, like, taboo that shit is, but I tried Swedish snus. That was cool, dude. Where's my money, that was cool. Man? Apparently a lot of people don't like it, but I liked it. I was drunk, though, at the time, but it felt fucking cool. You, like, put it on the top of your, mouth? Or whatever? I had it in for, like, 5 hours, though. Apparently that wasn't a good idea. The Noble Peasant, thank you. Very much. I don't think if you guys have realized yet, but I really didn't give a shit when I went to TwitchCon. German cars are the best cars. You can't say something else. Ferrari, Lamborghini, and all that stuff belong to VW. All that stuff you can say. The Germans are cars kings. Yeah, that's a film. You can't change it. Thank you, Dippity. I don't think anyone was talking shit about German cars, but I understand you need to protect your country. Handolo, thank you for subbing Brobama with the 22 minutes. Thanks, dude. Nah, fuck that. Look, I'm very responsible when it comes to that shit. I will never, ever, ever touch fucking drugs that are... Look, I'm fucking retarded, okay? But I have a limit of retardation. I can do weed and something else that I won't say. But, like, I know my limit. Like, if you're like, yo, man, you want to try this? I'll... Fuck no. No, I don't want to fucking try that. No, thank you.
Where's my money, bitch?
Because I know what... I know that I don't want to ruin my fucking life. Vozzy Bear, thank you for subbing. Appreciate it, man. No, not... I'm specifically talking about cocaine. Desire, thank you for the resub. Like, fuck that shit, dude. No.
Where's my money, bitch?
No, thank you. Two-legged panda, thank you for the resub. Appreciate it, man. Thank you very much. Thank you, man. Xanax bars? Is that like a chocolate bar? Little kid lover. It's kind of weird. Thank you for the resub.
Where's my money, bitch?
Thanks, dude. I did. I saw Black Mass yesterday. It was fucking good. Dude didn't even look like Johnny Depp. I want to watch The Martian as well. Doesn't that come out this week? Zalmoxis, thank you for the resub. I actually bought The Martian on the plane. It was so fucking boring. I don't know. I, like, on the way back, I was like, yo, I'm gonna read Audible. And it was, like, literally a log. It was a log of what he did. I'm assuming the movie is gonna be more exciting. Kazix, thank you for the resub. And JRD, thank you for the resub. I couldn't get into it, dude. It was, like, day five. I watered some plants. You missed my 26 decades, you dick. Lyric feels. Verdict, thank you for the $5, man. I'm sorry, bro. Hudak Wudak, thank you. Thank you. The movie will be boring as well. I don't know, man. I don't know. It's fucking Ridley Scott. I fucking love Ridley Scott. Ridley Scott's my boy. Siako, thank you for the resub. Who else? Oh, of course, I met a lot of Twitch staff. How the fuck did I forget that? I met Shark. Shark is a beautiful man, okay? Shark is a very beautiful man. I met him a couple of times. We hugged. We embraced. I talked to Ray a lot. Ray Arnold, you guys know he chills in the channel. Cool motherfucker. Cool dude. Very chill. I met LC. Hi, LC. How are you? I met LC outside of one of the panels or some shit, I think. We talked a lot. That was cool. I love the Twitch staff. They're all fucking badasses. Who else did I meet? There's so many fucking Twitch employees, so half the time I didn't know who was who. Was it before or after you did Coco, you sucked Gold Glove's dick? No. He sucked my dick. No. He fucking fellatioed all over my balls. Not the other way. Read the tweet again, bro.
Where's my money, bitch?
Fucking subject and predicate. Lyric Chan, if you can, try cannabis edibles too, responsibly. I don't know if I want to go all out. Syracuth, thank you for the resub. And Buttons, thank you for the resub.
Where's my money, bitch?
No. You got that shit wrong, dude. Mr. Colors, thank you for the resub. Was there any reaction at the event of Waffle killing Soda and Gold Glove? I did meet Muck. Yes. I knew I was forgetting someone. I did meet Muck as well.
Where's
yes.
Money,
I met Muck at PAX East too. He's a cool dude. We talk about shit. Fuck, what else happened, dude? I don't even know. Prime Time, thank you for subbing, dude. I didn't meet the CEO of Twitch, but I saw him. I thought he would be like more corporate and shit, you know what I'm saying? He'd be like, ugh, fucking kiss my ring, but he was just like very chill, laid back guy. Just like, you know, he looked like he was a cool guy, you know what I'm saying? But I didn't like personally meet him. Monfu, thank you for subbing. don't know. That's how I picture CEOs.
Where's my money, bitch?
The CEO hit the blunt.
Here's some money for some meth, bro. Enjoy.
Oh, for meth? Nah, dude, I'm sorry. That's not gonna happen. Thank you, though. I heard Chipotle delivers now, so maybe. Maybe. Prime time. Thank you for subbing. Welcome back, dude. We fucking missed ya. Any crazy stories? Dude, I've been talking about shit for the past hour. You're gonna have to watch the VOD after this. What I think about the Twitch changes? I think the shit they announced was pretty cool. I could see myself making it so not having a 24/7 channel, but I take Thursdays off, so maybe making it so every Thursday I have a new I have a VOD of a single player game that just plays on every Thursday, you know? I'm not gonna do a 24/7 bullshit. That's like weird. I like the hype as you're gonna go live. And if you have a 24/7 channel, that hype is gonna be lost. So yeah, on Thursdays we'll do like old single player playthroughs or something. That's cool. I don't really use whispers and shit, but I know if you're a viewer, you use that stuff a lot, so that's good for you guys. What up, Bart? I love you too, man. I miss you so much, baby. Thank you, Sunny Booty. Domo Seranto, thank you for subbing. El Diablo, thank you. Hello. Yeah, that's true, Fix. That's true. Hold up. I gotta think. There's more shit that happened. I just need to scan my brain.
Where's my money, bitch?
Sub Lyric, missed you. Kappa, remod Jakey. Wait, Jakey's not a mod? Jakey, say something. I fucking forgot what numbers you have. 120? 8? Res T with the 2 months. Thank you, dude. Alright. Sign anything weird. I signed mouse pads, I signed shirts, I signed, the TwitchCon badge is lots of those, the lanyard, or whatever it's called. Is it 120? Oh yeah, it is. I fucking signed... Shit, I don't know what else I signed. I think that's it. Nothing insane. The funniest thing was a mouse pad. That's it. I didn't sign any boobs, no.
Where's my money, bitch?
No. Blink twice if it was weed. Did you see it? So yeah, that was nice. That was interesting. Yeah, man, I met a lot of you guys. I met, like, Jeanette. She was cool. She's a fucking teacher that watches my stream. I was like, dear God, you must lose faith in humanity every time you tune in. She was nice. She reminded me of a mother, but she was young. What am I saying? Tell us what you think about the Invitational plus waffle killing soda with in a... I thought it was funny. When I was playing, I thought it was funny when, because like I was talking to Soda. He's like, yo, man, I'm going to go into like Pleasant Valley. I'm going to fucking kill everyone. And he was like pumped up and shit, and I was like, I'm just gonna like chill. And he's like, nah, man, I'm gonna go in and go into Pleasant Valley and like go all out. And he died. So it was funny, but you have to like, you know, he was so like confident and shit. And well, that didn't really work out, did it? What else happened? Yeah, I was surprised. Waffle did well, man. I had such boring-ass games in the Invitational, so... Whatever. I don't want to talk about it. It was literally a running simulator for me. Welcome back once again. Drink some whiskey. Promise it will help. Thank you, Zorber, for the 10 bucks. How's it feel that some 1G in the last 3 Survivor games? I guess. I think you're trying to get, like a reaction. Like, a salty reaction. When, like... Actually, personally, I don't really give a shit, because I was, like, the lowest point of my whole TwitchCon experience in terms of, like, give a shitness. So I'm fine with it. Blaze, thank you for subbing. What do you think about our role player, also called Forsen, now? How does Forsen roleplay if he plays Hearthstone? I don't get it. I don't get it, dude. Zio Ray and Luke, thank you guys for the resubs. Thank you very much. Yeah, it was good, man. It was good. The worst part was they had to, like, cut off. Did I just miss what he said? What do you think about our role player, also called Forsen now? I don't get it. I'm smoking Space Haze. If you know how strong this shit is, then tell me, because I don't even know, but it seems strong and smells and tastes good. I'm stoned. By the way, I missed you, Sen Poppy. Lirik feels... Thanks, man. Thanks, dude. Thanks. Can I play a game? I know, dude. I should play a video game. It's been like an hour. You think this shit's done? I bought this without reading the reviews. Are you fucking serious? It's been an hour, you fuck. God damn it. Wait, it looks like it froze, actually. Hold on.
Where's my money, bitch?
Honestly, that looks like it froze. I swear to God, I checked in the beginning of the stream and that's where it was. Oh my God. Did it freeze? Did that just go from 8.5 to 8.6? Oh, okay, it's working. It's just wicked slow. I don't know what's going on there. Alright, we're good. Hey, Lirik, welcome back. Thanks again, Wilhelmsen. Hey, Lirik, welcome back. Thanks for making my work from home Tuesdays a lot more fun. Ethereal Patch now has a rideable horse. Oh, God. I will jiggle. Hi, mate. Been watching, stalking you for over 2 years. Decided to sub and donate. Thanks for the entertainment. P.S. My girlfriend's pregnant. Happy days. Good luck, man. Good luck. I'm assuming that's good for you?
Where's my money,
yes?
Bitch?
Put the PS4 in rest mode. It downloads faster. Whatever. I got time. Skabuka. Sakuba, thank you for the resub. Almost 300 sub train in an hour. You can start playing the next 24-hour stream. Not really, dude. A lot of these are just resubs. We still lost like 500 subs. Nice to meet you at TwitchCon. You might not remember. I was at the Monster Cat party upstairs. I was embarrassed because I was wearing my Lirik shirt. Your brother is nuts. Thanks for not hiding in VIP like a lot of other bigger streamers. Okay. Are you saying at the convention? There weren't a lot of big streamers in the VIP, but I see what you're saying. No problem, man. I kind of remember seeing you a little bit. What up, Matt? I kind of remember seeing you. I don't know, that night's kind of blurry. All I remember from that night is I had like a long conversation with Forsen, and then I danced with Soda Poppin, and then Leo lost my shit. My bag. That I remember. Anything else is kind of blurry.
Where's my money?
Okay, let's play some games, and yeah, let's see if I remember anything. See if I fucking remember anything. Yep. Pretty much. Yo, fuck you, alright? She's cool. She's actually a really cool girl.
Where's my money, bitch?
Akame got kill. Thank you for the resub. Tronica, thank you for the resub. And Gemini, thank you for the resub. Appreciate it, guys. Oh, I did meet Sexy Hexy. Yes. I didn't talk to him as much as I did at PAX East, but... And I met Jimmy. I met Ark. Ark and I hugged it out. I was like, fuck your game.
What did you think of San Francisco? Great city emo.
Emo? Whoa. Yo, Space Moose, thank you for the $25, bro. I already explained what I thought about San Fran. I didn't really like it that much, bro, compared to, like, San Diego and stuff. San Fran was very,
Did you get anything cool from your fans? Also, awesome meeting you again. Sorry I was drunk, D.
Wow, Hellswat. Wow. Yes, I got something cool from you. Oh, shit, I did. I got these fucking stickers. Oh, fuck.
I gave them to Summit's wife, and we never met again, so she couldn't give them back to me. Some guy made stickers of my emotes, and they weren't really stickers. It was, like, really thick material that you could, like, put on your fridge and shit, and they looked amazing. Fuck! I should have got them. Damn it! They were so nice. I don't know who the guy was as well. Shit, man. You just reminded me. And yes, Hellswag gave me cards with a Lirik logo on the back. There weren't magnets. It wasn't a magnet. It was hard to describe. I don't know. Actually, that was stupid of me to say. I think it was a thick sticker. It wasn't a magnet. It was like a really thick sticker of material I've never seen before. And the guy printed shit and like left his card in to see if I was interested. And it was really cool, dude. Hope you enjoyed the barrier, weed man. Too bad I couldn't take a shot with you, though. Thank you, Wally. It was interesting. Inokis, thank you for subbing. Welcome back, Lirik. Glad you had an awesome time at TwitchCon. I drew your super pretty cat while you were away to kill time. Hope you like it. I actually saw the picture yesterday. I think I favorited it. It was very nice. Yo, before we move on, remember that I'm doing a shirt and shit, and we still haven't sold the shirt yet. The guy who made the previous shirt, this is his first mock-up of a design of the new shirt. What do you guys think? On Twitter, people liked it. What the fuck do you guys think, though? It's gonna be a bit more Lirik-y, but this is kind of like a new evolving Lirik skull logo, making it more original, making it more unique instead of a fucking skull with a shitty eye. And it's gonna be more Lirik, kind of like a phoenix rising from the ashes. This is the same dude who made the previous shirt that people fucking loved. Wait, what did you say? Like Corsair Gaming tattoo logo? What the fuck? Isn't Corsair like a ship? Cough, cough. Jakey, I modded you, man. What up, dude? Franco, thank you for the resub. Oh, I met Axiom, and I did. I met Axiom. Dude, he's funny. He like laughs at everything. That was funny shit. Axiom. What up, Mistrox? I know, dude, the old days. These are so backed up. What the fuck? How many subs did you lose? Like 500-ish? Yeah, Corsair logo is a fucking ship. How does this look like? Corsair is a computer parts company. No shit. And their logo is like a fucking ship. With three, like, sails. Right? Yeah. Welcome back. We miss all of you, but can you answer one question? Why you never keep smile? I'm really bad at taking pictures, man. I'm sorry. Vulu, Siraptor, thank you for subbing. I don't know how to put my face when I take pictures, so I just fucking stare at a camera. I've always been that way. Meet me in real life. I have a lot more expressions. You can ask people who met me. I'm just bad at it. You know, I'm sorry. I don't know what to tell you. I think the latest picture of Pocket looking like a vampire, I was like, high. I was out of it. I think it's on my Twitter. Oh, hey, glad you got turned up in SF. Wish you stayed through Sunday. Can't miss the Folsom Street Fair. I was actually going to stay for that, but yeah, they had like a BDSM fair on Sunday with like fucking weird shit. And yeah, I didn't stay. Thank you, Lirik. SF is dirty as hell because of the huge homeless issue and the gentrification of the parts of town where they are pushing out poor people out of their homes to make overpriced condos and stores. Ah, that would explain it. Das Worm Mitch, thank you. Appreciate it, dude. Alright, yo, let's play some fucking video games. Oh, is this it? Oh shit, you found it. Yeah, this is what he gave me. It was a printout and you have to feel it. It's like weird fucking fabric or some shit, I don't know. But he made this and it was cool, dude. He made like a bunch of emotes. He did Lirik 10 and stuff, and it was like wicked fucking cool. What, it's called T-motes? I'm gonna follow him. I might see about shit later. But yeah, it's like interesting fabric that I've never seen before, like material. Alright, hold on. German cars are the best cars. You can't... Dude, look how backed up this shit is. German cars are the best cars? Oh, I read that earlier. Thank you. If you leased your car, the value of the contract you signed will not change. However, the resale value dropped. Basically, the dealership is screwed. If that is the case, they will just have to take a loss when they take the car back. All right, thank you, Nighttown. I'm a daily stoner that has helped me through some serious stress and difficult times. Great to hear you thinking about blazing again. I hope to burn one with you one day. Lyric H. Thanks, dude. Sorry for the awkward hello. I'm forgetting to say my name at the H1Z1 event. Was a bit too stoked to meet you. Wait, sorry for the awkward hello and forgetting to say my name at the H1Z1 event was a bit too stoked to meet you. Bucks, I'm gonna be honest, dude. I don't fucking remember meeting you. That's probably why I don't remember. If you said your name, I would have remembered. Yeah, dude. But if I did meet you, man, it was nice meeting you. Thanks for the speech, man. Many people freak out about this. Finally, you fucking smoke weed. Love for France. Thanks, bro. We all know Dad gave you the snus. Tell us a story about Forsen. And then someone said Ferrari is owned by Fiat. Thank you. Fuck! Let's play games! A story about Forsen? I don't know, dude. Forsen and I just, like, talked about shit. You know when you just know someone who you could just, like, talk to? I don't know how to fucking describe it. You know when you just have someone who, like, you just talk about shit? And there's, like, no progress? You just talk about random stupid shit? That's literally... That's it. Like, that's it. It just, like, we just clicked, and we just, like, chilled and just talked about stuff. It's all that happened. Yeah, same with soda poppin'. Forcing more, but same with soda poppin'. You never had a friend before? I have, but, like, I don't know what the fuck you call it. That's called a friend? I mean, yeah, true, but, like... I mean, even my best friends, you have obviously, with, like, my best friends, like, I have conversations like that, but it felt like that. Maybe it was just, like, a friend. Sure. I'm wrong. Hold up, I'm loading this shit up. I think something's broken? No, we're good. Okay. Also, dude, oh my god. I met with the Discord guys. Dude, those motherfuckers are cool as fuck, and their program is 10 out of 10. I'm using that shit from now on. I just need to set it up. That, I'm gonna go all out with Discord. That shit is the coolest shit ever. Fuck TeamSpeak. So, mods, we're switching over to that shit. I'm gonna make it so we're gonna have a Discord for the whole stream. Make it so general is, like, muted. Have sub-only channels. Fucking, if you're banned in the channel, if you're banned, you can join the Twitch channel's Discord. Fucking go in there and a mod can unban you and everything. It was the greatest shit ever. I'm not even getting paid to say this. And it was amazing. So, yes. We're switching to... I'm gonna drop TeamSpeak, and I'm gonna drop Skype and shit. We're switching. Holy fuck. I got, like, a demonstration, and, like, my mind was blown. They're gonna make it so it, like, connects to your Twitch. So, you know how you guys vote for Sub Sunday? Or you go to my website and you authorize? It's gonna be the same shit. Connected to Discord. So, we're going all out. I'm gonna talk to Pwn so we can set everything up. I just, like, woke up late, and I was gonna do it today. But yeah, we're gonna do that. It's gonna be for non-subs and subs, but mainly for subs. Non-subs can join, but you can't talk. But you can, like, join and try to get unbanned and stuff. And apparently, it can't crash. So, I can open it up to thousands of people. That's happening. Dude, it's so fucking sexy. Go look at their shit, and, like, I tested out the sound quality. It was great. You can, like, literally post fucking GIFs and shit. You can have conversation. I don't know. It's good, man. It reminded me of IRC. I literally was like, this looks like IRC plus TeamSpeak. And they were like, that's what we were trying to go for. Just Brandon and Andy, thank you guys for subbing. Do sub hotline again? Maybe. Actually, someone came up to me at the meet and greet. And they're like, yo, man, my girlfriend, like, prepared this whole thing. And she was gonna say it on Sub Hotline, but you stopped doing it. Do you ever plan on bringing Sub Hotline back? We'll do it one day. I was like, we'll do it one day. Read the tweet again, bro.
Money, bitch.
Fucking subject and predicate. Lyric Chan, if you can, try cannabis edibles too, responsibly. I don't know if I want to go all out. Syracuth, thank you for the resub. And Buttons, thank you for the resub.
Where's my money, bitch?
No. You got that shit wrong, dude. Mr. Colors, thank you for the resub. Was there any reaction at the event of Waffle killing Soda and Gold Glove? Oh, yes, I did meet Muck. Yes. I knew I was forgetting someone. I did meet Muck as well, yes. I met Muck at PAX East too. He's a cool dude. We talk about shit. Fuck, what else happened, dude? I don't even know. Prime Time, thank you for subbing, dude. I didn't meet the CEO of Twitch, but I saw him. I thought he would be like more corporate and shit. You know what I'm saying? He'd be like, ugh, fucking kiss my ring. But he was just like very chill, laid back guy. Just like, you know, he looked like he was a cool guy. You know what I'm saying? But I didn't like personally meet him. Monfu, thank you for subbing. I don't know, that's how I picture CEOs.
Where's my money, bitch?
The CEO hit the blunt.
Here's some money for some meth, bro. Enjoy.
What? Oh, for meth? Nah, dude, I'm sorry. That's not gonna happen. Thank you, though. I heard Chipotle delivers now, so maybe. Maybe. Prime Time, thank you for subbing. Welcome back, dude. We fucking missed ya. Any crazy stories? Dude, I've been talking about shit for the past hour. You're gonna have to watch the VOD after this. What I think about the Twitch changes? I think the shit they announced was pretty cool. I could see myself making it so not having a 24/7 channel, but I take Thursdays off, so maybe making it so every Thursday I have a new I have a VOD of a single player game that just plays on every Thursday, you know? I'm not gonna do a 24/7 bullshit. That's like weird. I like the hype as you're gonna go live. And if you have a 24/7 channel, that hype is gonna be lost. So yeah, on Thursdays we'll do like old single-player playthroughs or something. That's cool. I don't really use whispers and shit, but I know if you're a viewer, you use that stuff a lot, so that's good for you guys. What up, Bart? I love you too, man. I miss you so much, baby. Thank you, Sunny Booty. Domo Seranto, thank you for subbing. El Diablo, thank you. Hello. Yeah, that's true, Fix. That's true. Hold up. I gotta think. There's more shit that happened. I just need to scan my brain.
Where's my money, bitch?
Sub Lyric, missed you. Kappa, remod Jakey. Wait, Jakey's not a mod? Jakey, say something. I fucking forgot what numbers you have. 120? 8? Res T with the 2 months. Thank you, dude. Alright. Sign anything weird. I signed mouse pads, I signed shirts, I signed, the TwitchCon badge is lots of those, the lanyard, or whatever it's called. Is it 120? Oh yeah, it is. I fucking signed... Shit, I don't know what else I signed. I think that's it. Nothing insane. The funniest thing was a mouse pad. That's it. I didn't sign any boobs, no.
Where's my money,
bitch? No. Blink twice if it was weed. Did you see it? So yeah, that was nice. That was interesting. Yeah, man, I met a lot of you guys. I met, like, Jeanette. She was cool. She's a fucking teacher that watches my stream. I was like, dear God, you must lose faith in humanity every time you tune in. She was nice. She reminded me of a mother, but she was young. What am I saying? Tell us what you think about the Invitational plus waffle killing soda with in a... I thought it was funny. When I was playing, I thought it was funny when, because, like, I was talking to Soda. He's like, yo, man, I'm going to go into, like, Pleasant Valley. I'm going to fucking kill everyone. And he was, like, pumped up and shit. And I was like, I'm just going to, like, chill. And he's like, nah, man, I'm going to go in and go into Pleasant Valley and, like, go all out. And, he died. So it was funny. But you had to, like, you know, he was so, like, confident and shit. And, well, that didn't really work out, did it? What else happened? Yeah, I was surprised. Waffle did well, man. I had such boring-ass games in the Invitational, so... whatever. I don't want to talk about it. It was literally a running simulator for me. Welcome back once again. Drink some whiskey. Promise it will help. Thank you, Zorber, for the 10 bucks. How's it feel that some 1G in the last three Survivor games? I guess. I think you're trying to get, like... like a reaction, like a salty reaction, when, like, actually personally, I don't really give a shit, because I was, like, the lowest point of my whole TwitchCon experience in terms of, like, give a shitness. So I'm fine with it. Blaze, thank you for subbing. What do you think about our role player, also called Forsen, now? How does Forsen roleplay if he plays Hearthstone? I don't get it. I don't get it, dude.
Where's my money?
Zio Ray and Luke, thank you guys for the resubs. Thank you very much. Yeah, it was good, man. It was good. The worst part was they had to, like, cut off a lot. Did I just miss what he said? What do you think about our role player, also called Forsen, now?
Money,
I don't get it. I'm smoking space haze. If you know how strong this shit is, then tell me, because I don't even know, but it seems strong and smells and tastes good. I'm stoned. By the way, I missed you, Sen Poppy. Lyric feels. Thanks, man. Thanks, dude. Thanks. Can I play a game? I know, dude. I should play a video game. It's been like an hour. You think this shit's done? I bought this without reading the reviews. Are you fucking serious? It's been an hour, you fuck. God damn it. Wait, it looks like it froze, actually. Hold on.
Where's my money, bitch?
Honestly, that looks like it froze. I swear to God, I checked in the beginning of the stream and that's where it was. Oh my God. Did it freeze? Did that just go from 8.5 to 8.6? Oh, okay, it's working. It's just wicked slow. I don't know what's going on there. Alright, we're good. Hey, Lyric, welcome back. Thanks again, Wilhelmson. Hey, Lyric, welcome back. Thanks for making my work from home Tuesdays a lot more fun. Ethereal Patch now has a rideable horse. Oh, God. I will jickle. Hi, mate. Been watching, stalking you for over 2 years. I decided to sub and donate. Thanks for the entertainment. P.S. My girlfriend's pregnant. Happy days. Good luck, man. Good luck. I'm assuming that's good for you?
Where's my money,
yes?
Bitch?
Put the PS4 in rest mode. It downloads faster. Whatever. I got time. Skabuka. Sakuba, thank you for the resub. Almost 300 sub training in an hour. You can start playing the next 24-hour stream. Not really, dude. A lot of these are just resubs. We still lost like 500 subs. Nice to meet you at TwitchCon. You might not remember. I was at the Monster Cat party upstairs. I was embarrassed because I was wearing my Lyric shirt. Your brother is nuts. Thanks for not hiding in VIP like a lot of other bigger streamers. Wait, okay. Are you saying at the convention? There weren't a lot of big streamers in the VIP. But I see what you're saying. No problem, man. I kind of remember seeing you.
A little bit.
Where's my money,
what up, Matt? I kind of remember seeing you. I don't know, that night's kind of blurry. All I remember from that night is I had like a long conversation with Forsen, and then I danced with Soda Poppin', and then Leah lost my shit. My bag. That I remember. Anything else is kind of blurry.
Where's my money?
Okay, let's play some games, and yeah, let's see if I remember anything. See if I fucking remember anything. Yep. Pretty much. Yo, fuck you, alright? She's cool. She's actually a really cool girl.
Where's my money, bitch?
Akami got killed. Thank you for the resub. Tronica, thank you for the resub. And Gemini, thank you for the resub. Appreciate it, guys. Oh, I did meet Sexy Hexy. I did chill a lot with Pocket as well. Usually in conventions, me and Pocket always chill. What else happened? Fuck, dude, there's so many people I met, like, no one, like, rubbed me the wrong way. That's kind of, like, the cool thing about Twitch. It's all like-minded people, you know? You're all fucking nerds. So it's, like... Yeah, you're all fucking nerds, but, you know, you can be a nerd, but you still can't really connect with someone. Like, you don't know how to talk to them, if you know what I'm saying. Yeah, like, I don't know how to describe it, but, like... Sometimes in conversation, you sit there and there's awkward silence, and usually those are the people you don't really connect with, if you know what I'm saying. And at TwitchCon, there was always something to talk to with like everyone I saw, whether it was like chilling with like Leah or Soma or like fucking Soda Poppin' or like Tim or like Forsen. Oh, and I met Wreckful. Dude, I kind of fangirled a little bit over Wreckful because, like, you know, I played a lot of World of Warcraft and stuff. He was a cool motherfucker. I slow danced with him at the, on Saturday. But we were, you know, we were both shit-faced. At least I was. And he's a cool dude. Him and his girlfriend are really fucking cool. I didn't think we'd connect, but, it was, like, wicked fucking cool talking to him. Very, very cool. Very cool guy. Very cool dude. That happened. That's why I'm sick? You think so? I'm not that sick, as long as it doesn't get worse. Like, I can function. It's more like annoyance. Like annoying sickness. Stuffy nose and sore throat. With a hint of losing my voice. Yeah, dude, the concert. I actually got a shout out at the concert. That was kind of cool, but it wasn't streamed. People were telling me they like shouted me out, and I was like, oh, check that off the fucking list of accomplishments. Get a shout out at a fucking EDM concert. Xenocide, thank you for subbing. Pruny, Andres, Axehead, Vindicator, thank you guys for the resubs. Yeah, I didn't do any panels. No, I didn't want to do any. I only did the meet and greets. I barely played any. I didn't even check the show floor. I was so fucking busy. There was so many other stuff to do that I never checked half the shit. Like, I wanted to try Paladins and stuff, and like, honestly, fuck games. When you go to a convention, the last thing you want to do is play video games, actually. So I'm not that pissed or annoyed. Morph, thank you for subbing. I didn't meet Crip. I slightly met Trump, but it was like, hi, and then that, nothing happened. I went to dinner with Amaz, but we, you know, we didn't go all out. Who else did I meet? I met, a bunch of smaller broadcasters that were cool. Moroccan Tomato, thank you for subbing. Yeah, I did meet T-Mac. I'm just thinking, there's so much shit that happened, I'm trying to, like, scan it in my mind. I'm trying to fucking remember everything. I didn't meet Echo. I didn't. I know I met Pocket. I said that. I hung out with Pocket a lot. JP I met, Ammunition, Tally, Lula. Fairlight I met. Trick2G I met. Yeah, dude, Trick2G is cool. He's a cool motherfucker. I met him at PAX East too. He's a cool guy. Dan's Gaming, at PAX East, I hung out a lot with Dan and Waffle. This time, I was nowhere near them. That's what I'm saying. I had a completely different experience because I hung out with absolutely different people. Like, people I didn't think I'd hang out with at all, I hung out with. Yeah, that's what happened. Like, PAX East, it was like Dan, you know, Waffle, you know, just chilling. You know, like, the people who are just, like, very, like, laid back. But, like, this shit, fucking insane with, like, Forsen and stuff. Like, I would have never thought I'd hang out with Forsen, but I literally hung out with him the whole fucking con. I did. I slightly met Day 9, like, a little bit. That's, like, I shook his hand and that was it. I met DJ Wheat. He was a cool dude. I talked to him for a little bit. I think on Thursday I talked to him for a little bit. I did. I slightly met Raynad. I was like, hey, man, what's up? I'm Lirik. He's like, yo, I know you, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, we knew each other. And that was that. Oh, I did meet Kappa. Oh, that was fucking funny. They had, like, this VIP area. Like, I kind of... That's where I met Wreckful for the first time. There's, like, this third floor VIP area. Kind of just to, like, rest and chill. Like, after... If you don't want to... You know, if you just want to calm down a little bit, that's where I went. And, I saw fucking the Kappa dude. And it was funny, because, like, I saw him walking in to the VIP area, and it literally he had like a blank stare on, and I started laughing my ass off because I knew that he probably got fucking surrounded and like mobbed beyond belief, and he like finally made it to the promised land. It was funny as fuck. Like, he had death on his face. Can you imagine that shit? I'd be scared. Like, literally, he, like, you could just tell he was so fucking burnt out when I saw him. I was like, yeah, I know what happened to you, bro. Don't worry about it. I feel you, bro. I feel you, man. Calm down. I feel you, man. But yeah, you could tell he's like, don't fuck with me. I don't want to talk to anyone. Cyber Skull, thank you for subbing. Appreciate it, man. Miss Harvey, no. I did meet Bike Man. We didn't get to talk too much, but I met Bike Man. Always a pleasure. After my second signing, as I was leaving, okay, I had the most awkward, I had like, you kind of have to be there, but I did meet Darude, but it was really fucking awkward, because I don't know why he was there, actually, now that I think about it, why he was in that area. I was, I got done on Saturday with my second signing, and it's like, okay, man, hour's up, you gotta go. And I was walking away, and, like, the area where you have to walk out of, right next to the meet and greet, Darude and I think his girlfriend or wife were right there. And I, like, walked up to him, and I was like, hey, man, oh, I like your stuff. And, like, we shook hands, and we just had, like, an awkward stare for, like, a minute and a half. And then I was like, and I just, like, walked away. I don't know, man. It was really awkward, though. You can, it's hard to describe. You have to be there. But it's, like, usually, like, a follow-up, but I didn't know what to say, because it's, like, I don't, like, fully like him. All I know him for is fucking Sandstorm. So it was really fucking weird. And I just, like, walked away, because I didn't know what to say. And, yeah, it was so fucking weird. Now that I think about it, it's really fucking weird. Longtime viewer here from Morocco. Love watching you since the Day Z days. Finally upgraded my credit card to sub to my favorite... I missed it. Hold up. This shit still needs to catch up. That was weird, man. I wasn't expecting it to be there, but it's like he was there, so I might as well, like, you know, introduce myself a little bit. Leet Bomb, thank you for subbing. Lazy Me DK, thank you for the resub. Cyber Skull, thank you for subbing. And Moroccan Tomato, thanks again, dude. Yeah, that was interesting. I didn't see Cutie Pie, no. I'm trying to remember who else I saw. Trying to remember. Oh, I met Captain Sparkles. He was kind of cool. Cool dude. Shit, what else, man? I'm thinking. Friday and Saturday were, like, the biggest fucking days. Sunday, nothing happened. Sunday was just, like, go home. Majority of people left on Sunday, I think. I did meet Witwix, yes. All right, Bike, I got you. I'll do it right now. Yo, Bike, I already got one, dude. I'm good. Thank you, though, man. I already got one. Thank you, man. Yes. Man vs. Game, I didn't meet. Yeah, dude, I didn't fucking meet Man vs. Game. Like, at all. I didn't fucking see him. Whatsoever. Yo, I heard. Oh, my car is affected. I felt really sad. You know the whole VW bullshit with the emission bullshit? Apparently, all these cars are worth less than they actually are now. So, like, my Audi is even worth less. I don't know how it works, though, because I don't know. It's like the residual value when you sign the contract when you buy a car. Does it uphold that residual value, or can that value change now that they fucked us? I don't know how it works. I don't know. I leased my car, so fuck, man. I loved Audis too. Like, I wanted to get another one once my lease was up, but I'm not entirely sure. I'm like in a fucking suit, and told you that it was like me who was the under the sea guy, and you were like, don't ever utter that word again, that man is sacred. And like, he met me and at the fucking con. He didn't take a picture or anything. He just like was like, yo, man. Yeah, it was like nice to meet you and stuff, or it was cool finally seeing you. I don't know, that was fucking surreal, because it was kind of like a blast from the past as well. Money, it's like, seriously, man, the dude who sang on the stream. Oh, I also met, oh, on the street. Oh, it was so fucking random. The dude who, in A3L, fuck, I wish I took a picture with him. The dude who plays, okay, there's, in A3L, there's Grandpa, and then there's the other Grandpa, the one with, like, a higher voice. I don't know how to describe it. Maybe we'll see him one day soon in A3L. I see him sometimes. He usually wears, like, that black hat with, like, the spikes, the red spikes. I saw him. He came up to me. He's like, hey, man, you recognize my voice? And he did a little bit of it. And I was like, oh, shit. And old man Joe, was that him, T-Mac? Was that him? Also, I talked to T-Mac a lot. T-Mac's the fucking... He's a cool dude. T-Mac's a bro. I talked to him a lot. He was shit-faced, though, I could tell. At least on Thursday. Yeah, I met him on the street. That was weird. He's like, yo, man, recognize the voice? Yeah, he was at the music event. He was. You're right. You're right. I'm sorry. I'm missing a lot of your guys' shit. I'm just talking a lot. Shadow, thank you for subbing. Nailed, thank you for subbing. Erish Kagal, thank you for subbing, dude. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Black Goose, thank you for subbing. Coffee. The Orbean, thank you. What up, guys? Toxibomb. I did. Dude, Summit and I always connect. Like, we're cool. I didn't hang out with him too much, but we hung out. Well, we had to Uber to the Twitch offices to do some shit and, like, get a tour of the Twitch offices, just him and I. And it was cool. The Twitch offices are fucking... Honestly, it doesn't really look like an office. It just looks like a chill area. It's like, you just walk in, and it's like, cafeteria. And then you take a couple of steps, computers everywhere. Take some more steps, computers fucking everywhere. You know? And, like, they have a bunch of cool fucking pictures. And, what else? They have, like, a kitchen and a cafeteria. Like, a bunch of help-yourself food. I don't know, I kept looking at the food there. That was weird. You could just do, like, just fucking go and eat there and just, like, go back to your desk. And when we went, a bunch of people were, like, playing Counter-Strike and stuff. Slackers! Aldo the Apache, thank you for subbing. Oh yeah, they do have a bar. They do a fuck ton of alcohol there. Actually, you're right, Shorty. I like how you knew that, and I didn't point that out. Nailed. Thank you for subbing. And Obscure, thank you. Yeah, it's like literally, it's like ramen. Just pick it up, heat that shit up, and go back to your computer. It seemed more like a big ass dorm or a big apartment, not really an office. Which isn't bad. It seemed like a really chill environment, if you know what I mean, right? Like a very, very chill environment. Like I could see myself working there and just chilling. But yeah, and then we had lunch there. Oh fuck. Oh my god. How could I forget? Dude, there's so much stuff that happened and I'm like skipping shit. Thursday was an experience because Thursday, the Monster Cat party was fucking crazy. That's what happened. That's the problem. Okay? Cause like, there's so much shit that happened, but it's because we stayed up all night. Cause I didn't even sleep Thursday and I went to the con on Friday without any sleep. After my flight and everything. Because it was so insane. Thursday, Monster Cat party, I met Soda Poppin and Tally. Tally I did shots with, Soda Poppin I did shots with, and then Soda Poppin and I danced, and he kept telling me to like pick him up, and then we both ate shit on the ground, and then he messaged me and he's like, dude, I don't remember what happened, and I told him he molested me, but I liked it. That's what I remember. And then that happened. And then after that, I think Soda, like, he just left because he was so drunk. And, what do you call it? I met Gold Glove. Oh my fucking god. Gold Glove is a character. That man is fucking insane. I've never seen someone talk so much about sucking dicks in my entire life. Until I met Gold Glove. So that was fucking weird. That was actually really weird. Oh my god. I'm not really sure what happened there, but I remember we were like in an Uber for like an hour looking for a place to eat. And like Google kept saying there were IHOPs open for 24 hours, but all the three we went to were all closed. And then we found like a Denny's in some shitty ass hotel that we ate at with like a bunch of people. So that was weird. And, yeah. I don't even remember what happened, actually. It was so fucking weird. That was a trip. Rygar, thank you for subbing. And Fevi, thank you very much for subbing. Julia TV, I don't think I saw you there, Julia. But thank you for subbing. I don't remember if I did. I don't think I did. I remember you from PAX East. Gus Wern, thank you for the resub. Yeah, man, that was fucking insane. But yeah, that happened. Did he suck your dick? Well, that's what I'm saying. I don't remember. I do not remember. Did I like San Fran? No. Fuck no. I didn't like San Fran at all. I'm gonna be honest with you. I fucking love San Diego. I've been to Comic-Con like 3-4 times. San Diego is fucking gorgeous. It's like 70 degrees, palm trees, and it's like very clean. San Fran, what the fuck? Okay? I don't know what is going on in San Fran. Granted, maybe the convention was kind of in a shitty place, but like it was straight up hobos, people playing drums, and every time you exited, there was fucking traffic. I've never seen so much fucking traffic in a city in my entire life. And what's funny is, that was every single day in fucking San Fran. And it was funny, because on Sunday when I got back to Boston, holy shit, it's like night and day, dude. Boston, it was like clean as fuck, it was beautiful, no traffic whatsoever. And then like we went to the Italian part of Boston and ate there, it was fucking beautiful. I was like, thank you, thank you. But granted, when I went to the Twitch offices, there was traffic there. But it was a lot nicer because that was the financial district of San Fran, where that's located. So, that was nice. Maybe it was just in a shitty part. Dude, I got, like, it was late nights every time in San Fran, and I don't think I've ever been asked so many times for a fucking dollar. Like, it was insane. I was scared half the time. Like, someone was gonna
I don't know, dude. It was some creepy shit. I'm just saying, if you're a girl, never walk alone. Honestly, even if you're a guy, never walk alone in San Fran. You're most likely gonna get fucked. Literally and metaphorically. Spofon, thank you for the resub. Compilation and Mad Hatter UI, thank you for subbing. Oh, dear God. That shit is fucking freaky. I don't know, man. It's like drunk hobos everywhere. Holy fuck. Yeah, I'm being dead serious. Never walk alone at night in San Fran. At least where near the convention area and all that shit. Have I been to New York? I have been to New York, but I don't remember New York being like that ridiculous. I've been to New York like 4 times and it's never been that ridiculous. I can finally get laid. You know what, man? That's one way of looking at it. Dynamus, thank you for the resub. What else happened? So yeah, Thursday was a trip. Friday. Guys, by the way, you guys who tipped and shit, it's so backed up that it hasn't updated on my program yet. That's why. Just hold on. It's literally queued. So I can't even read what you wrote to me until this calms down a little bit. I did meet Gears. I did meet Gears. It was fucking cool meeting Gears, man. It was awesome. Gears has been with me since, like... Where's my money, bitch? I've known Gears since the start of... streaming. Basically. And, it was fucking cool seeing him. Gears was all sweaty. I don't remember that. I don't remember that at all. But like, yeah, I've known Gears since like the beginning of streaming, and finally seeing him was like wicked cool, dude. It was wicked fucking cool. It was really, really fucking cool. You know, seeing the man behind Lyric Thump. Seeing the man behind this shit. And all the art he's made, you know. Gears is taller than you? Yeah, he is. It was cool, man. It was cool. It was awesome. I did, I everyone was 20 plus. There were like a couple of young kids. I'm not saying that's bad. I'm not saying that's bad. If you're like 15 or whatever, that's fine. But, I'm just saying majority was like 20 plus, which is fucking cool. You know? And then, like, I signed 4 or 5 mouse pads, which is kind of funny. And, I took a picture with a baby, which was kind of funny. I met these Japanese dudes. Yeah, I met these Japanese dudes. There were, like, 3 Japanese dudes. Apparently, they, like, I didn't know, but Twitch opened up, like, an office in Japan recently. They were fucking cool. That was an experience. And then this one girl cried when she met me. That was fucking weird. What else happened? I tried the Vive. Dude, the Vive was fucking sick. The Vive was cool as fuck. actually, I don't do this. I don't do this, but, what the HTC... sorry. The HTC Vive... basically it was like this little area in the back right of the convention. You walk, it's like a black box. And if you like go there, it's like reservations are full. Like you can't get into the Vive. So I like walked up, I was like, oh shit, like is it full? And they're like, yeah. And this guy, actually no, it wasn't a guy. My bad. It was T-Mac. I was walking around with T-Mac. as I was about to go, T-Mac was like, yo man. To the HTC guy, T-Mac was like, yo man, you're making a big mistake not letting him in. Do you know who he is? And he's like, who are you? I was like, Lyric. And then he's like, 1 second. And then they made room for me and I tried out the Vive. I don't do name drops like that. Like, I'm not a fucking asshole. But like, that was kind of funny. Cause like, I had some leverage because of that. So that was cool. And I tried the Vive. And that was fucking insane. Because I have the Oculus Rift, And I haven't used it yet, but like the vibe, you walk around in like 3D space. You don't like sit there with your thumb up your ass. You like walk around and like do shit. And it's cool if you're gonna like hit the, if you're gonna hit, or if you get close to the box, it shows a grid pop up. So like if you put your hand out, you touch the wall. So you don't like fucking run into a wall or something. There was like this one VR experience where you're like basically on the Titanic and there's like this big ass whale that comes and tries to scare you. And then there's this other one. Oh, the coolest one is you draw shit in 3D space. That was fucking mind blowing. Like Gears would love that shit. I wrote hello and drew a cat, and like it's like all around you. It's so hard to describe it. It looked amazing, and you can make it like snow on yourself and shit. And then I played Fruit Ninja in VR. You know, like that iPhone, the phone game where you slice fruit, but like, in virtual reality. It was fucking awesome. Yeah, it was pretty cool. And like when she handed me the controllers, like first when you put it on, you're just like chilling, and then like. It was a girl. She's like, okay, I'm gonna put the controllers in your hands, and like you take the controllers, and when you lift up your hand, it's so fucking weird because you don't see your arm. All you see is like a controller in like virtual reality, and it feels like you're a fucking robot, kinda. It's hard to describe. It's one of those things. It's really fucking cool though. And I met Almir. You guys know Almir chills in the channel a lot and usually drops fucking tip bombs. I fucking met Almir, wicked cool guy. That picture of me in the wheelchair, that was Almir's VR. His company is working on virtual reality. That's why I was in the wheelchair. Cause actually, can I talk about? I think so. Why not? The way it worked is like it's The Walking Dead VR. They're working on a new game, and it's like one is not VR, one is VR, this one is VR, and you're meant to be a dude in a hospital, and you're weak, so you're on a fucking wheelchair, and there's like this chick that like pushes you around. And you're trying to escape the hospital when there's zombies all over the place, and they give you a shotgun and you're supposed to aim and fucking shoot the zombies. It was cool. It was really fucking cool. That's why. So yeah. It was an experience. It was a fucking experience. Slarbutt, thank you for the resub. Retardio, wake up at 5 a.m. Anna Daisy, how are you, Anna? Afro, thank you for the resub. Coffee, thank you for subbing. Dev Xer, thank you for the resub. Sinsta, Solid Snake, Moose, Serbal Grog, Solus, thank you guys. Thor Bini, thank you for subbing. Phoenix, Blue Sandwich, Prophet Junk, Jordan, fucking Sita, he says Cargus, thank you guys very much. All of you guys for the resubs. Arishakal 2, thank you for subbing, man. And Toxie Bomb, Eating a Unicorn, Deer Hunter. Thank you guys very much. You're too kind. This is so backed up. What else happened? Thursday? Let me go in order. Thursday was kinda, wait, hold on. Fuck, I don't even remember. Thursday we landed, and then I think we just did dinner Thursday. No. Thursday was the monster cat party. That was fucking insane, dude. That's when I got shit-faced. Mainly because of Towly and soda popping. That wasn't my fault. They made me do a lot of shots. And, like, my mouth is small, so I can't, like... Where's my money, I can't bitch? Do a full one.
Hey, Lirik. Welcome back. Missed the streams, Lirik.
Lirik. Thank you very much for the $50, Wilhelmsen 12. Thank you, man. Thank you very much. You're crazy, dude. Yeah, I can't do, like, a full shot. I need to do, like, 3/4 and then another sip. or else it, like, overflows. I don't fucking know. But, yeah, that happened. I don't really do shots ever. It's fucking nasty. But, yeah, that happened, and I met a bunch of people. There was this one guy at the party who came up to me, and he was, like, wicked drunk. He's like, yo, man, like, never stop what you're doing, man. You're, like, an inspiration, man. Ugh. Like, dude, you're so cool, man. And he was like that for like 5 minutes, and I was just like nodding my head. And then he walked away, and he was like, and then I think he fell because he was so drunk, and people had to help him up. So that was cool. I met Waffle there. I barely hung out with Waffle at all. I was so fucking, like, I don't know. I hung out with, like, so many other broadcasters than Waffle. Like, PAX East, it was literally did everything with Waffle. This one, I fucking mainly hung out. Thursday, I hung out with, like, I hung out with JP and Shannon Sacriel and, that's kind of it. And then, like, the rest of the con, I literally hung out with Soda Poppin', Leah, Forsen, and Wreckful sometimes. Like, the whole con. And they were fucking cool as hell. Forsen is the fucking man. Like, him and I connected. We, like, we fucking talked, like, I think I talked to him the most the whole con. He's a really laid-back, chill dude. Fucking cool as fuck. Leah, she's fucking cool as hell, too. Yeah, man, Forsen's the fucking man. That guy, I fucking connected with him, like, instantly. Leah's cool as fuck. She's easy to talk to and stuff. Very cool. You know, Soda Poppin', I've never met him, you know? And, like, fucking... Oh, also, I hung out with Scoots. What up, Scoots? Yes, I did. Scoots is always, a sight for sore eyes. Fucking Soda, like, you know... The problem with, like, internet shit is that you don't really know people. Other than, like, the bullshit Twitch chat spreads about you. Or about someone else. Right? But, like, whatever. That's, like, the only thing I knew about him. You know? That's it. I never met him, but I met him at TwitchCon, and we fucking hung out for, like, 2 days. Like, we ate together, and we just fucking chilled together. For a long fucking time. And I also met Tim kind of the same way, but not to the extent of Soda Poppin', because I've known about Soda, like, you know, since the beginning. But Tim I knew slightly of, and Tim was cool as fuck too. Very easy dude to talk to, and we chilled, and it was like, it was just fucking cool, man. It was just really fucking cool. But yeah, Tim, Soda, and Leah, and Forsen were the main people I hung out with a lot. Yeah. Oh, shit. Okay, for all the old school viewers out here, I don't know if you remember, it was like Daisy days, old school Daisy mod days. If you remember, this is for old school, probably only like 200 of you guys remember. There is a scene, or not a scene, but there is a time when me, Shorty, and Waffle were running around Cherno, and there was a guy singing Under the Sea, that Little Mermaid song, okay? And I met him at the meet and greet. Yeah. He was at the meet and greet. Yep.
Where's my money?
And he was fucking there. And I was like, my mind was kind of blown. And he's like, yeah, man, like, after that happened, I, like, donated to you. I don't know. I'll leave that to the other motherfuckers. I heard, like, 2 million cars are affected. Mine's 2015, so mine's probably fucked, too. Wait, it's only diesel? Someone said that. Only TDI engines? I'm almost positive my car says TDI. I don't know. Someone look up a 2015 Audi A4 and tell me if it's affected. Milkshake, thank you for subbing. It's only diesel? Oh, okay, never mind then. Ha! We're good! Never mind. Wait, what Audi uses diesel? It's only TDI, and if it's on a lease, you can probably swap it for a gasoline. If you have TDI, it's a diesel. Dude, I don't fucking know. I thought diesel was only for, like, trucks and shit. Most of the Euro ones. Dude, I don't know shit about cars, alright, man? I just fucking press a button and put gas in my car depending on the octane, alright? You fucking European people who are, like, born with car knowledge. I am African Jesus. Thank you for subbing. Thank you, man. I don't know, man. I have a diesel Audi. One second, guys. Hold on. All right. What else happened? Actually, no. I got some tea with ginger in it. You learn about that stuff in driving school? Really? My driving school was a week of an old man telling me stories about fucking crashes, actually. I don't know what fucking driving school you went to, but my driving school was the old man talking about that and me cheating off this Indian kid. Not really cheating, but we just, you know, I was like, we just pretended we were working together on the test. Everyone in the class was. He didn't even fucking notice. It was one of those like, oh, yo, I think this is right. But like, I didn't know what the fuck I was talking about. And I just like circled what he circled. Endangered species. Thank you for the resub. Bitch, I haven't gotten a ticket in 5 years. I don't need any training. And I speed like a motherfucker. I'm just really lucky, apparently, because I don't know how I haven't gotten a ticket yet. Yes. Yeah, one thing for sure, I like, I smoked some weed yesterday, and, well, I tried driving, and, they don't lie. You definitely fall asleep very easily if you try driving. I did take a lot, but I had to get home. That was interesting. They're like, yo, man, you know, I have, you know, I think I almost fell asleep like 4 times for like a second. It was like 4 a.m. though. That accounted for it too. That was interesting. Yeah, dude, I'm actually, this is kind of random, but I'm going to probably, I'm gonna, because it's decriminalized in mass, so I'm probably gonna get a license and start smoking. Dead serious. Rerose and Giratina, thank you guys for subbing. That was a very random leeway or leadway to a different subject, but dead serious, I'm gonna do that. I used to smoke like freshman year of college, and after TwitchCon, I miss it, so I'm gonna do that shit. I'm down. Do it like maybe once a week. Not go all. I know some people who smoke every fucking day. I'll do it like once a week. I might get like the oil and vape. Keep it simple and easy instead of getting like a bong. I'm not joking. I'm being dead serious. I don't know how it's a big deal. Like if you've smoked before, it's like really not that big of a deal. You guys are acting like it's insane, but it's really not. Hello, Lirik H. I missed you. Can I get a motherfucking Lirik H? Alright, today's stream is like catch up, get back into the groove. I fucking missed you guys. I just need to let go of a lot of things until we get back into the groove. Yeah, it's like, you know what it reminds me of? Everyone always like gets all like, ooh, when you talk about like sex and shit. It's the same shit with weed. People are like, oh my god. You can't talk about that, man. Like, 420, you know? Shut the fuck up. It's really not that bad. No, it's decriminalized in, like, mass. And, you can go get a license. Just in case. And, you can buy, like, oil online. And just put that shit in a vape. I'm gonna do that. I just need to do some research on vape. And find out something good. No, I'm not high right now. I did have a great sleep though. YouTubeBot, thank you for subbing. Welcome back. You have been missed. What up, Zorber? I know, dude. Welcome. Thank you. Will you do it on stream? No, like I said, like once on a weekend, maybe at night. Or on Thursdays or some shit. I did. I tried Swedish snus as well. I don't know if I should say who gave it to me, just in case. I don't know how, like,
I don't know how, like, taboo that shit is, but I tried Swedish snus. That was cool, dude. Where's my money, that was cool. Man. Apparently, a lot of people don't like it, but I liked it. I was drunk, though, at the time, but it felt fucking cool. You, like, put it on the top of your, mouth or whatever. I had it in for, like, 5 hours, though. Apparently, that wasn't a good idea. The noble peasant, thank you very much. I don't think you, if you guys have realized yet, but I really didn't give a shit when I went to TwitchCon. German cars are the best cars. You can't say something else. Ferrari, Lamborghini, and all that stuff belong to VW. All that stuff you can say. The Germans are cars kings. Yeah, that's a film. You can't change it. Thank you, Dippity. I don't think anyone was talking shit about German cars, but I understand you need to protect your country. Handolo, thank you for subbing Brobama with the 22 minutes. Thanks, dude. Nah, fuck that. Look, I'm very responsible when it comes to that shit. I will never, ever, ever touch fucking drugs that are... Look, I'm fucking retarded, okay? But I have a limit of retardation. I can do weed and something else that I won't say. But, like, I know my limit. Like, if you're like, yo, man, you want to try this? I'll... Fuck no. No, I don't want to fucking try that. No, thank you.
Where's my money, bitch?
Because I know what... I know that I don't want to ruin my fucking life. Vozzy Bear, thank you for subbing. Appreciate it, man. No, not... I'm specifically talking about cocaine. Desire, thank you for the resub. Like, fuck that shit, dude. No.
Where's my money, bitch?
No, thank you. Two-legged panda, thank you for the resub. Appreciate it, man. Thank you very much. Thank you, man. Xanax bars? Is that like a chocolate bar? Little kid lover. It's kind of weird. Thank you for the resub.
Where's my money, bitch?
Thanks, dude. I did. I saw Black Mass yesterday. It was fucking good. Dude didn't even look like Johnny Depp. I want to watch The Martian as well. Doesn't that come out this week? Zalmoxis, thank you for the resub. I actually bought The Martian on the plane. It was so fucking boring. I don't know. I, like, on the way back, I was like, yo, I'm gonna read Audible. And it was, like, literally a log. It was a log of what he did. I'm assuming the movie is gonna be more exciting. Kazix, thank you for the resub. And JRD, thank you for the resub. I couldn't get into it, dude. It was like, day five, I watered some plants. You missed my 26 decades, you dick. Lyric feels. Verdict, thank you for the $5, man. I'm sorry, bro. Hudak Wudak, thank you. Thank you. The movie will be boring as well. I don't know, man. I don't know. It's fucking Ridley Scott. I fucking love Ridley Scott. Ridley Scott's my boy. Siako, thank you for the resub. Who else? Oh, of course, I met a lot of Twitch staff. How the fuck did I forget that? I met Shark. Shark is a beautiful man, okay? Shark is a very beautiful man. I met him a couple of times. We hugged. We embraced. I talked to Ray a lot. Ray Arnold, you guys know he chills on the channel. Cool motherfucker. Cool dude. Very chill. I met LC. Hi, LC. How are you? I met LC outside of one of the panels or some shit, I think. We talked a lot. That was cool. I love the Twitch staff. They're all fucking badasses. I met... Who else did I meet? There's so many fucking Twitch employees, so half the time I didn't know who was who. Was it before or after you did Coco, you sucked Gold Glove's dick? No. He sucked my dick. No. He fucking fellatioed all over my balls. Not the other way.